right now, I'm kind of taking off the parts I don't want. And it's photographic paper, so I could take off just by using, like a chemical. It's almost like bringing the light back in.
Yeah, I was doing these meditation paintings that were like almost like an image of a tree of life, you know, like looking down and leaves kind of dispersing. Meditation paintings all started in the center, because a lot of my paintings had been kind of very decentralized. I've been using flowers on and off for a long time, but I don't really see them as flowers. The image of a flower having been taken away, which is literally what I do. Things eventually break down. Our cravings is that things, as we see them or as we want them, will stay that way. Nothing does. The optical paintings that had to do with the relationship, really, of the viewer to the space and the inability for any image to cohere. The cell paintings, mutated cancer cells, very up close, so they seem very abstract. But in fact, they were the most realistic paintings I ever made. These new paintings are clock paintings. They just have to do with time fading and time passing. Certainly beauty is a hook. And I think things can't be beautiful enough. And to have light coming from inside of them, you look at it and you say, where does that come from? It's so beautiful. That's what they told me at the UN. That's the first time they've ever appointed an artist as a UN Goodwill Ambassador, a visual artist. Ultimately, the question comes down to, can any one person make a difference? In this case, a refugee camp in Africa, and work with children who had been formerly abducted, boys as soldiers and girls as sex slaves. Maybe to tell their story, using imagery as a rehabilitative tool. That if I thought that was even possible, and you know, I do think that's possible. These children saw and understood that they can actually make something that other people can look at and recognize. I feel it made them feel very valuable. Just by moving around this little brush, with this colorful stuff on the end of it. No matter what happened in their past, that they could look to a future. And what would they want that future to look like? I just think that kind of created this like explosion of color. A lot of what they wanted to be is expressed in their work. I want to be a mechanic, they draw cars. I want to be a dressmaker, they draw clothes. When I left, a lot of them told me they wanted to be artists. So May 12th at the UN, there will be a lot of the work of the children, and it will be for sale, and the proceeds are going to go to the United Nations Office of Crime and Drugs. But they will be followed up in terms of their schooling. I made a catalog, and I'm curating the exhibition, and I guess the appointment ceremony, whatever that means. I plan to go back and do it again with another group next year. I actually believe the best part of my work might not even necessarily be in my work, to ask questions but also provide some kind of relief. In Buddhism, it's called tanglin. You breathe in and you breathe out. And when you breathe in, there's no way that you can't breathe in the suffering that you see. When you breathe out, you can breathe out a kind of enthusiasm and hopefulness.